Hydrogen is not the ultimate solution to reduce emissions, but it's a complementary technology with battery electrical vehicles.
So we do really a testing here and also a secondary research, which means analytical work, in order to support the policy DGs in Brussels when they make regulations and when they have to make important decisions for the European Union.
In this system, we have a high temperature furnace, because this is, as Darina, my colleagues say before, high temperature fuel cell. So that is based on a ceramic material that is able to withstand with high temperature, so it's operating at temperature between 700 and 800 degrees, even 900. The same material can also operate in a reverse mode, and providing electricity is able to split the water, producing hydrogen.
So what we are doing here is it's a test bench where proton exchange membrane fuel cells is connected to assess the performance and the efficiency. The parameters that are assessed or measured, monitored, are pressure, temperature, flow rate, humidity. But this system, which is commercialized, has an autonomy of 700 to 800 kilometers. And the advantage is that you refill your car in a matter of 3 minutes, 4 minutes.
We are giving possibilities to scientists, to different research organizations to reach us and to make use of our facilities. So whatever we have here, it can be used also from external organizations.
Seeing how, during the past 10 years, how the technology has improved, it has a social impact and environmental impact on our society.
So all these new activities that will be coming in our life, they will create new jobs and growth and prosperity for Europe.